Hi there, welcome to Nep Invest. In my opinion, it is really important to have a look at the bear case for every single company you own in your portfolio, because as a shareholder of a company, more than likely you are going to be quite optimistic about the potential future of that company. So I like to just pull back and think of the bear case for every single company I own and think about the one or numerous things I don't like about that company. And in today's video, I'm going to talk about the one thing I don't like about CSL. This is a company I have owned quite frequently in the past. And right now, my plan is to own CSL for the long term. But I'll talk about the one thing that might make me sell. And to be honest with you, it is nothing to do with CSL itself, the business or the business model. So you'll understand that as I talk about this one thing I don't like about CSL. We'll also discuss the financial year 22 results for CSL. And to be honest with you, based off the valuation of this company really didn't, you know, set anything alight with their results. So not much growth, but that was to market expectations. And I do expect CSL to grow quite well over the next few years. And when I say well, because this company has a market cap of $140 billion, any growth in revenue or profit around 10% or even above 10% would be this company hitting it out of the park, so hitting a home run out of the park. So I think if this company can achieve that, that would be good news for the company and its shareholders. Now, before we have a look at CSL, the one thing I don't like about the company right now, and have a look at their financial year 22 results, these are the five companies that I'll be taking a look at in future videos in regards to their financial year 22 results: Xtech, Energy One, BlueScope Steel, Data3, and CarSales. If you have a company you'd like me to discuss, particularly in regards to their financial year 22 results, just leave that company in the comment section. And there is a possibility I'll actually have a look at that company and do a video on that company in the future. One of the first things I do when I am researching a company is determine the quality of that company before moving any further. Because how I deal with high-quality companies compared to low-quality companies is quite different. For instance, high-quality companies, I'm more interested in the value and not that interested in the trend and the underlying sentiment, while for low-quality companies, it's the complete opposite. I'm more interested in the trend and the share price and the sentiment rather than the value at that point in time. So for CSL, what is the quality of this company? And I think there is very little doubt. You couldn't argue or successfully argue that CSL is not a high quality company. In fact, I'd probably argue it's one of the highest quality companies on the ASX. Now, you could actually determine the quality of a company just by looking at the long-term charts. And this is the weekly chart for CSL going back to 2011. And the share price has been increasing ever since then. Now, it doesn't go up in a straight line. There's been some dips. And those are the sort of dips you are looking for if you want to take a position in a high quality company. Now, share price of CSL over the past 2.5 years has been going sideways. I'd probably call this a consolidation period because the valuation of this company has been a little bit too stretched, a little bit too much enthusiasm in this company, particularly between about 2017 and 2020. In fact, during 2019, start of 2020, we saw this company's share price exponentially rise, and that's never a good thing. Now I'm going to discuss one of the things I don't like about CSL, and to really hit home this point, I am showing you the Microsoft chart between 1997 and 2013. Now, during the tech bubble back in 1999, the share price of Microsoft rose from about $12 to a high of $60. And then their share price pulled back to be between about, say, $25 and $35. And then the share price went sideways for about 12 to 13 years. Yes, the share price of this company did not move higher, did not move into an uptrend for another 13 years. So from 2000 to 2013, the revenue per share of this company increased from $2.07 to $9.19. So yes, the revenue for this company quadrupled during this period where the share price went sideways. Not only that, the earnings per share of this company, tripled from 85 cents per share to $2.58. So how Could the share price of this company just go sideways when there is financial and significant financial expansion for Microsoft? It all comes back to multiple contraction. The market was much less willing to pay a premium for this company moving forward. And we can always look at the historical P/E ratios for any company by using any sort of site. So I use sometimes Ticker, sometimes I use Guru Focus to show us, or to show me, the historical P/E ratio, price to sales ratio, or price to operating cash flow of a company over a certain period of time. And for Microsoft, the P/E ratio in 2000 was 47. By 2013, the P/E ratio had fallen to 13. This is classical multiple contraction. So even though Microsoft was increasing their revenue, earnings per share, and profits, share price was going sideways because there was a period of multiple contraction here. What we want to do, and ideally what we want to do, is own a company when there is financial expansion and also multiple expansion as well. And multiple expansion is when the P ratio or any valuation ratios increase through time. So for instance, Apple has gone through a significant multiple expansion over the past 6 years. Back in 2016, Apple's P ratio was something like 12. Now it's well over 30. So even though the company has grown, the shareholders of that company have benefited from an additional increase in the share price through multiple expansion. And this is the one thing I don't like about CSL, because there is a possibility we are at a point in time when share price of CSL is just going to go sideways for an extended period of time as we see a period of multiple contraction occur. No idea how long this could happen for. No idea if this CSL is going through that. But the P/E ratio of CSL right now is above 40. And there is a possibility, particularly if we see problems in the market, if we see a significant correction in the market, that the price or the share price of CSL won't be higher than it is now for the next 5 to even 10 years. Now onto the financial year 22 results for CSL. Before we have a look at revenue, profit, and operating cash flow, the price of CSL is $278. And in fact, on the 26th of September, when I recorded this video, the share price did increase to above $280. And the main reason it increased by about 2 or 3%, and when the overall market was down between about 1.5 or 1.6%, was because there was some positive outlook there by some analysis of this company. Now onto the revenue. $14.9 billion in financial year 22, $3.2 billion in profit, $3.7 billion in operating cash flow, and the earnings per share for CSL in financial year 22 was $6.83. So if we compare the earnings per share to the share price, you can see right away that the P/E ratio of this company is quite elevated. We'll have a look at the valuation metrics later in the video. And this is one thing I don't like about this company, is just the elevated valuation, the premium attached to this company right now by the market. There is a reason why there is a premium, because it is one of the highest quality companies on the ASX, maybe the highest quality company. And a lot of people want to pay, are willing to pay a premium to own this company. But as we saw with Microsoft, even though Microsoft was a high quality company back then, probably a high quality company right now, it went through a period of time, a 13-year period of time, where the share price went absolutely sideways. So I can envisage that sort of future moving forward for CSL. But CSL is a growing company, and this is the revenue growth for CSL from 2012 to 2022. If we calculate, this company does report in US dollars. So these revenues are in US dollars. The results I showed you in the previous video or the previous slide was in Australian dollars. So just keep that in mind, that some of these numbers might be a little bit different than what I showed you in the previous slide. But the main thing is the growth in revenue over time. So over the past 10 years, revenue has grown at 14.3% per year. That's pretty significant for a company that has a valuation of well over $100 billion. Over the past 5 years, revenue has grown at 10.3%. And concerningly, over the past 3 years, revenue has only grown at 5.6%. So you could argue the revenue for this company is starting to slow down, but also probably would argue that this company has experienced some headwinds because of COVID-19, particularly with their blood plasma collection sites in the United States. And one of the reasons why some of these analysts are excited and about the future of this company is because of that blood plasma collection and the future they have, or this company has, in the United States. Now to the financial statements, and I'm going to try to get through this fairly quickly. Now, when I first start looking at the financial statements of a company, I'll have a quick look at the revenue as I'm going from last year to this year. Then I'll go to the statement of cash flows and then work my way back. Now, because CSL does report in American dollars, their statement of cash flows is fairly similar to American companies. And fortunately, because it is similar to American companies, I can see changes in working capital in their statement of cash flows. I don't need to look at any notes the company has released. So the main thing I'm looking for here is any significant differences between the profit and the cash flows from operations, and why there was a significant decrease in operating cash flow from last year to this year. So CSL had operating cash flow of $3.6 million last year and $2.6 million this year. So why was operating cash flow $1 billion less this year than last year? So let's have a look at working capital changes. That's where we're going to understand why there was a big drop in operating cash flow. The first thing that really stands out here is an increase in inventories of almost $600 million. And the second thing that stands out here is a $200 million decrease in trade and other payables. So combined, those are some of the reasons why there was a significant decrease in operating cash flow from last year to this year. It was just a change in working capital. So that's nothing to be concerned about. The one thing you might be concerned about is the profit has decreased from last year to this year, from 2.9 million to 2.8 million. So that could be one thing to be concerned about CSL. But the market did not react negatively to these results, even though profit operating cash flow fell. And one of the reasons the market did not react negatively is the market expects this company to continue to grow or return to growth phase from next year. And one way we know that, or one of the reasons we know that, is because the company did release an outlook for financial year 23. So let's have a look at that outlook now. One of the things I really look for when a company does release their financial year results, and this will be found in the presentation for a lot of companies, is any sort of outlook, particularly if the company provides some numbers. But even if a company doesn't provide some numbers, you can get an overall sentiment of what the management of a company is feeling or thinking. But fortunately, the management of CSL has provided financial year 23 outlook with some numbers. So this company expects revenue to grow between 7 and 11% in financial year 23, so return to growth in the next financial year, and profit to be between 2.4 and 2.5 billion. They've also mentioned here that this financial year 23 guidance excludes CSL 5-4 earnings and acquisition transactions costs. And that guidance for CSL 5-4 will provide it at the first practicable opportunity. So these numbers that the company has provided could be a little bit conservative. And CSL has been known to be conservative in the past with their outlooks. Now to some valuation metrics of CSL. And again, one of the reasons, one of the things I don't like about this company right now is just the valuation. I do think the market is too willing to pay a premium for this company. I would love the P/E ratio of CSL to be like 20 instead of 41.9, price to sales ratio 8.99, and even price operating cash flow really high, much higher than I would prefer at 36.2%. Oh, 36.2, not percent. Now, I did calculate a reverse DCF and calculated the growth this company has to experience to justify the current valuation. And that growth, that earnings per share growth, is 22.7% over the next 10 years. So this company needs to grow at a fairly quick rate. So I don't think this company will be able to achieve that sort of growth. So I do think there is a possibility that the share price and the valuation of this company could be under a fair bit of pressure at some point in time in the next 5 to 10 years. And that is one thing I don't like about CSL at this point in time. So nothing to do with the business at all. It's just the valuation and that the market is too willing to pay a premium for this company. Now, even though I do consider CSL to be one of the highest quality companies on the ASX, And for high quality companies, I don't really care about the trend in the share price or the underlying sentiment in the company. I still will have a look at the chart on occasion for a company just to see if the share price is dropping. And if the share price is dropping, that means the company is better valued than it was before the drop. So what I'm looking for, particularly in companies I don't own, I'm looking at any significant drop as an opportunity to buy that quality company at much better values. So with CSL, we know the share price is in a long-term consolidation period, about a 2 years, what did I say, 2.5 year consolidation period. And you can just see that with the daily chart. The share price is not in any sort of trend. And we have seen short-term trends, like we did see towards the end of 2021 into the start of 2022. In fact, share price dropped from $320 down to $240. So a nice 25% drop in share price in a fairly short period of time. That's the sort of drop you want to see for any company you think is high quality and you want, just want to buy in at a better price. Now, if CSL share price dropped from $280 like it is now, down to $140, I'd be going all in because that would make this company really cheap in my opinion. So that's the sort of thing I'm looking for in high quality companies. And that's why I still pay attention to the charts, even though the trend in the share price is of no consequence to me. That's all I have for this video, looking at CSL, their financial year 22 results. And the one thing I don't like about CSL right now is just the valuation. I really wish I could buy CSL at a PE ratio of 20 because that would be absolutely amazing. But again, sometimes you do have to pay for quality. CSL is one of the highest quality companies on the ASX, and that's the reason why there's a high premium attached to this company. So if you want to own CSL, you will have to pay a premium at this point in time. Possibly at some point in the next 5 to 10 years, the share price of this company will drop to such a point where the PE ratio might be, say, 20 or 25. And that would be an amazing opportunity for those who don't own CSL at this point in time. So if you do have any questions, any thoughts, just leave those thoughts and questions in the comment section of this video. Otherwise, I'm not a financial advisor. If you do need financial advice, make sure you seek out someone who is qualified and can speak to your own financial needs. That's it for this video. Have a good day. Bye.